I like solving the puzzle. I like the CSI. I also like frogs, and so I also feel a real drive to help understand how pesticides and other chemicals are affecting amphibian populations.
Hayes and his students have been looking for clues in the Salinas Valley.
50% of the U.S.'s agricultural products come out of California. Something like 85% of the country's lettuce comes out of Salinas, 90% of the almonds. It's called the salad bowl of America. California uses more pesticides than any other state. The second biggest is Florida. Things like chlorpicrin is used out here on the strawberries. Chlorpicrin is a nerve gas. These are guys who are applying it, they're out there picking it. Methyl bromide is a fumigant, something they pump into the soil. What are some of the other big ones, you guys?
Diazinon.
Some atrazine. This will all end up in the river that we're working in here. It might look like we're out in a bush somewhere, but 15 feet on either side, we're surrounded by agriculture, and the runoff ends up in this river. All of the algae is a result of all the nutrients, because a lot of fertilizers are used in agriculture. And once those fertilizers get into the water, you get these blooms of algae. I wouldn't say it's a sign of a healthy river. This is a site where we typically find compromised immune systems, tadpoles that aren't able to fight off disease. Our data so far suggests that the mixture of pesticides causes an increase in stress hormones. And those stress hormones cause immunosuppression, which leads to the inability to respond to any kind of disease pathogen.
Hayes is testing the effects of chemicals like atrazine, a common herbicide.
We have a whole family of animals where we've eliminated the female chromosome.
Specimen 01.
These animals that we know are genetic males have been exposed to atrazine for their entire life. And many of these genetic males now are turning into females. You can see he's got eggs that kind of look like they're in a sac. These are actually yolked eggs ready to be laid. What's happening is you're skewing sex ratios. You can get genetic bottlenecking, which can cause crashes. And quite frankly, if you're a genetic male, it'd be nice if you developed as a genetic male. And now we have a chemical very common in the environment that's effectively sex reversing animals.
I want to show you something pretty amazing, scientifically speaking. The one that's sort of remarkable is this pair. These are both males. The one on the bottom, acting as the female, we affectionately refer to as Darnell. He's a genetic male that not only acts like a female, he lays eggs like a female. He, she, has been exposed to atrazine all of her life. I don't even really know how to reference it. This is Darnell's third clutch. So Darnell has sons and daughters that we've grown up. You can see eggs in the bottom. This is actually her second clutch for today. He, she has been copulating for getting close to 24 hours now. This is probably one of the most remarkable things I've seen in my work. But I personally have mixed emotions. I'm very excited about the science and trying to understand the mechanism. But on the other hand, I am worried. This is the most common contaminant in ground and surface water and drinking water. And the level of atrazine that it took to make this male turn into a female is 3 times less than what's allowed in our drinking water.